rise of conservatism. Conservatism is basically the opposite of liberalism, which we discussed in another lecture. The rise of conservatism occurs between 1945 and 2000, and it occurs in three phases: 1945 to 1968, 1968 to 1980, and 1980 to 2000 and beyond. The rise of conservatism started in the 1940s, particularly the late 1940s, after World War II and after the New Deal. Conservatism was a response to the New Deal. There were many who thought that the programs produced by the New Deal was socialism. So conservatives were against those programs, were against state socialism, as they called it. Conservatism was also pro-state segregation and anti-miscegenation, which is basically intermarriage. This was in response to the desegregation laws, such as Brown versus the Board of Education, which will come later in the 1950s. But those who were pro-state segregation and anti-miscegenation were primarily called Dixiecrats, and now they were in the southern states. And they were kind of an offshoot of the Democrats at the time. Conservatives opposed the Civil Rights Bill. They didn't believe in hiring equality or quotas based on race, which came about because of the Civil Rights Bill in the 1960s. Conservatives believed in pro-local self-government and limited interference with individual rights. And for the Dixiecrats, they saw segregation as an individual right. In the 50s, conservatives were anti-communist and suspicious of unions. This is right in the heart of the second Red Scare. In the 1960s, they were pro-Vietnam. They opposed the Great Society and the War on Poverty. They saw this as socialism and welfare. They didn't believe that government should be involved in interfering in the private lives of people. So they were pro-states' rights as well. In the 1970s, it was about single issues. Conservatives were pro-capital punishment, pro-gun rights, anti-abortion, and anti-ERA, or Equal Rights Amendment, whereas liberals were anti-capital punishment, anti-gun rights, or gun control at least, pro-choice, and then pro-ERA. From 1980 to 2000 and beyond, conservatives believe in small government. The Republican Party has always believed in small government, but this really becomes part of their platform from 1982 to 2000s and still. You will see the rise of the religious right in the evangelicals and their influence on conservatives. They will advocate for prayer in schools. They were also pro-private retirement or anti-social security. They believed in a separate retirement system, that people should be saving and that people get dependent on Social Security for their retirement, and then they don't save money for their retirement, and that's a problem in society. And that ends your rise in conservatism. If you have any questions, please let me know.